Well, the price of veggies is about to get even higher, unfortunately. Farmers in southeast Queensland are still recovering after a tornado-like hailstorm swept through the Lockyer Valley region. For more, we're joined by Lockyer Valley Growers Association Vice President Mitch Bringlekine in Forest Hill and Director of Red Rich Fruits, Matt Polisi. Nice to see you guys. Mitch, first up to you. You're a grower yourself, and when I heard this news the other day about the devastation up there, I just couldn't quite fathom it, and my heart bleeds for you. How bad was the damage?
Yeah, good morning, Carl. Just firstly, if I could think of a fruit that starts with D, it'd certainly be hailed here if it was in this field with us. And that's the disappointing thing. Friday afternoon, we had a very devastating hailstorm. It ripped through here like a tornado. It was ripping shed roofs off, house roofs. It's blowing these irrigators over. One behind me here, that there'd be about 10 of these that are blowing over in the Lockyer. And just devastated crops.
Awful.
Crops that were luscious, some ready for harvest, and now they're gone.
Well, it's just a lot of money for you, a lot of hassle and expensive. Consumers are going to see this too, aren't they? What are they going to see in terms of prices, therefore?
Yeah, look, there's going to be some market disruption. Farmers are often very resilient. They often do try and have some plan Bs growing in other locations. But the fact of the matter is that some farms have completely been wiped out. And that's, you know, on their own farms, that's really, really hard for us and the growers that have been affected specifically.
Man, I feel so genuinely sorry for you all. I know how hard you all work up there, and to have it so close to harvest is just awful. I appreciate what you're saying this morning as well. Look, Matt, how badly is this going to affect the wider market, and how are we going to see prices filter through?
Look, there's going to be a lot of disruption. So on pumpkins, spring onions, broccolini, you're going to see 2 to 3 weeks where higher prices, probably 10 to 20%. Mm-hmm. But the Australian supply chain is very diverse, very robust. So you've got farmers that are growing multiple regions. So you won't see it as much. And the good news for consumers is that fruit and vegetables are still great value and deflated year on year. So you can still buy loads and loads of fruit and vegetables for
some cheaper ones too.
There's lots of good value in the world. So in vegetables, I'd be looking for eggplant, carrots, asparagus, tomatoes are really good value. And in fruit, melons, and I know you like watermelons. So watermelons, rock melons are really good value. Peaches and nectarines are delicious. The growing conditions, right, that warm summer, and R2E2 mangoes.
All right, thank you for that. And to Mitch out there on the land, and to all the farmers who are affected, I hope there's some government assistance that heads your way.